Welcome to today's lecture. So today we'll be dealing with part 11 of our revision of environment and ecology for the prelims. So today's class will be focused on the climate and physical features, right? So in the context of the environment. So today we'll be looking at the Siachen Glacier, Mount Etna volcano. So this is an active volcano that is continuously in use because of its eruptions. And later we'll see about the Strait of Hormuz, tidal water glaciers, Kazin Sara Lake. अभी ये सबसे बड़ा लेक बन गया है, लाइक सबसे हाईएस्ट लेक बन गया है. लेटर वी विल लुक एट द दाल लेक एरिया विच इज टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज द इको सेंसिटिव जोन. लेटर वी विल सी अबाउट यूरेशियन ऑटर, इट्स काइंड ऑफ एनिमल, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट लाइक मंगूस. सो लेटर वी लुक एट द गौर दैट इज बैक इन द वाल्मीकि रिजर्व, टाइगर रिजर्व, इट्स अ टाइगर रिजर्व ऑल्सो. रिमेंबर लाइक गौर इज अदरवाइज कॉल्ड एज इंडियन बाइसन, राइट. And now there is only one white giraffe left in the world. So this is only there is only one white giraffe, and the remaining has been threatened by the poaching. Later and finally topic we will look at about the India's cold wave zone, right? Sorry, the first topic is about the Siachen Glacier. So see, Siachen Glacier, this lies in Karakoram Range. So this is a source for many rivers. Like Nubra, which is a tributary of Shyok River. Remember, Shyok is a part of Indus water system. Karakoram Range is also known as the backbone of the High Asia. So in this region it has K2, which is the highest peak which is there in the Indian territory. See, remember, the Siachen Glacier is the line of control between India and China, very tense, okay. So it is the second longest glacier in the world and in the non-polar areas, okay. So some more information about Siachen Glacier. So this lies immediately of the Great Drainage Divide that separates the Eurasian Plate and the Indian Subcontinent. Remember, the Himalayan and these regions are considered as the third pole, right? We have discussed this about in the last class. And the Siachen Glacier is the world's highest battlefield. And another aspect that is in new, that is the Karakoram Anomaly. So by this anomaly has been occurring. See, due to climate change, there is high rate of glacial retreat that has been occurring in the Himalayan region. But on the contrary, you see that in this Karakoram Range, it is not the same. And while glaciers are good enough here, why? Because according to Down to Earth magazine, it is found that because of the agricultural activities to certain kilometers, extent of kilometers around this Karakoram Range in the areas of China, India, etc., this agricultural activities have produced much amount of moisture in the air. So this moisture in summer goes and falls as snow in this Karakoram Range, and this strengthens the glaciers there, right? So this has been termed as Karakoram Anomaly. Next topic is about the Mount Etna. So this is there in Italy, and this is active and active volcano type, and this is the largest active volcano in entire European continent. So the remember, this supports higher biodiversity, right? Because of this, this is has been recognized as UNESCO World Heritage Site, and this Mount volcano is on the convergent boundaries, right? Next topic is about the Strait of Hormuz, okay. So this is between Iran and Oman, right? So this links the Gulf to the Gulf of Oman and further to the Arabian Sea. So in the political context also, if you see, in 2015 there was an agreement between the Iran and the JCPOA, that is a Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. So this is between the Iran and the P5+1. So year one is the Germany. And the P5 countries, you know, the US, UK, France, China and Russia, right? So there was an agreement for the controlling of the Iran producing the nuclear bombs or the missiles. In reciprocation, the sanctions on the Iran will be removed by these countries. So this was the agreement. However, in 2018, US has withdrawn this deal. And firstly, they started sanctioning on the Iranian oil. So in retaliation to this, Iran they have given the threat like they will be closing the Strait of Hormuz, right? So why this is important? Because the most crude petroleum from the OPEC countries goes through this strait. So in this context, this is very much important. So next, next topic is about the tidewater glaciers. So these are nothing but the valley glaciers that flow all the way into the ocean, right? So what recent study has found that the underwater melting of these tidewater glaciers occurring 100 times than what we were thinking. So what happened? So when the glaciers melt because of the water stored in the land, this significantly raises the amount of the water going into the ocean. This is leading to the sea level rise. On the extra information here, remember, on the other context, any ice cubes normally in the ice is just like ice cubes in the glass. So it neither increases the water level, right? So recently, natural enthusiasts have found one lake called as Khajin Sara Lake in the Nepal, and it has set a record as the world's highest record. So earlier it was Tilico, even this was in Himalayan region, right? Another lake that was very much in news is the Pangsongso Lake. So this is very much in news because of the standoff between India and China, right? So this is at a height of 4,350 meters in the Ladakh region. So this is the brackish water lake. Okay, so there is a salt content there. So, and remember, this is not a part of Indus Water River Basin. And this is the world's highest saltwater lake, right? Next topic is about the Dal Lake. And this has been news because of the shrinking of its area from 31 square kilometers to 24 square kilometers. So Jammu Kashmir, presently Union Territory, has set a 10-member committee on this lake to whether you have to declare this as an eco-sensitive zone or not, right? So more information about the eco-sensitive zone, will be notified by the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change under the Environment Protection Act 1986. So this is generally declared around 10 kilometers around the protected areas, national parks or sanctuaries, right? So in some area, in some context, it also extends beyond 10 kilometers, okay, depending on the significance there. Next is about Eurasian otter. So as I said, it generally looks like mongoose. So this is why it is in news. It has been spotted in the Chilka Lake, near in Chilka Lake. So according to IUCN, this is nearly threatened. So in the protection in context, it is there in appendix 1 in the sites. So it's like endangered species which you cannot export or import here. And it is there in Schedule 2 of Indian Wildlife Protection Act. So it's the habitat. This is found in the Europe and Asia. That's the region. It's called as Eurasian, right? So in the Himalayan foothills, so in southern Western Ghats and central India. So more information about Chilka Lake. It is Asia's country's largest brackish water lagoon. Okay. So this was the first lake to be notified in the under Ramsar Convention of the international importance, right? Here the species Irrawaddy dolphin can be spotted, and especially near this Saptapada Island, okay? And recently Odisha government has come up with the Odisha Water Wetland Authority. So this improves the integral management of this, okay, of this Chilka Lake. So recently it is found that the Gaur is back in Valmiki Reserve, Tiger Reserve. Okay, so Gaur is nothing but the Indian bison. So this is there in the Bihar Tiger Reserve. So not on the good news is that it not only came back, there is a significant increase in their numbers because of the increase in the grassland cover. So remember, so the best generally it is said that in any kind of conservation efforts, the best conservation effort is protecting its habitat. So it ranks first. So it is the largest extant bovine in the world. Gaur is the largest extant bovine in the world. So it is vulnerable under IUCN. Okay. regarding the more information about the Valmiki Reserve, two rivers flows, that is the Gandak and Masan River. So this is situated in the Gangetic Plains biogeographic zone of the country. So recently there were only limited white giraffes in the world, out of which two have been killed by the poachers. So these were there in Kenya. Okay, so presently there is only one. So this is has been there in the red list of IUCN in the appendix 2 of the sites. So the white color of this giraffe is because of leucism, which is a rare genetic condition that causes cells like they don't have any kind of pigmentation, right? So this leucism is different from albinism. So in this context, there is no melanin production at all, right? So recently there is a news about the India's cold wave. According to IMD, so this year we can see the warm winter. So generally this cold wave is spread in the regions of Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Delhi, Haryana, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, and to some extent in Gujarat and Himachal, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Bihar, right? So generally how this cold wave occurs, we have this western disturbance that comes, and this brings air from the top, like into the northern parts of India, and intensifies the cold conditions. So but it has found that these western disturbances have been disturbed because of this we see warm winters, right? So please continue with your preparation, and please share your feedback about our classes. Let us meet in our next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.